After the release of his book this week, Russian writer Dmitry Gluchovsky, known for his exploration of social and political structures, speaks to Euronews about his motherland and his mission to recruit readers to his humanistic cause. Science fiction could be considered a safe haven in which one is able to expose society's flaws but can also avoid direct finger-pointing. You paint a gloomy picture, but is it recognizable? Does it get people's attention and scare them?
The picture is rather recognizable. Everybody who read the book Future told me that it's not about the future, but about the present, even though the official theme is immortality. In the times of the Soviet Union, science fiction was the only method, the only loudspeaker, through which it was possible to talk about society's problems or the political system and to criticize them both, while the so-called real literature was totally controlled by the state. No matter how popular my books are, 100,000 readers is nothing compared to 140 million TV viewers who feel hatred, intolerance and contempt for other people or nations. All my efforts are fruitless. I'm fighting TV on my own. And actually, I'm not even trying to fight it. My mission is just to find readers and recruit them to my rather humanistic club.
In one of your articles, you come to the conclusion that there is a tendency to glorify Russia's role in world events. It seems that Russians are more preoccupied with their neighbors and the rest of the world rather than with what they have on their own plates.
We're always forced not to think about the quality of the food on our plates, low salaries, poor health care or lack of opportunity to travel, but about what's going on in Honduras or what America is doing in Latin America. It's okay to reflect upon this kind of thing, and then the story repeats itself after a short while. We're back to the tradition of distracting people's attention as a strategy. Apart from that, in the Soviet Union, sorry, I mean Russia, there is a strong imperialistic complex. Russians used to be part of a huge empire, the biggest country in the world, which we still are. We're facing the after effects of a war that we lost, war with Western civilization, with the United States. And so there is a great need to restore this subjective feeling of superiority.
The characters of your best-selling series Metro are constantly wrestling between fear and courage. You explicitly say that your inspiration comes from Russian society. Under what conditions would you say courage triumphs over fear?
We can't say that Russians are cowards. Russians are brave, even desperately brave, I would say. But the problem is that their despair and courage are not always used for the right cause. The biggest discovery I've made during the last year and a half in observing what is happening in Russia was the sudden need for an enemy, both an internal enemy and an external one as well. We were offered an enemy. At first we clashed with our nearest neighbor. Now we're clashing with Western civilization, which we're supposed to despise and distrust. Maybe soon we'll be inspired to hate them, if necessary.
Подготовка идет к тому, чтобы начать уже внушать ненависть, да, если будет необходимость.